Chapter 13, Understanding. Throughout the annals of our history are innumerable references to great minds, who contributed each in their own way, toward the evolution of our society. The contributions they made are very diverse. One such man is Dr. Daniel W. Fry, Ph.D. He founded groups all over the U.S., one of which was the Los Angeles Group of Understanding, where I was privileged to lecture on two occasions. Over the years, the groups have conveyed government-suppressed information to thousands of people, and it is because of this that his name with those of many other contributors should go down in history as names to be remembered. Dr. Fry, a highly qualified research scientist, was contacted by the space people. I believe it was at first a traumatic shock to him. Like me, he found it extremely hard, at first, to believe it possible. However, once he was convinced that it was not a gag, he spared no effort to help humanity. The following is an extract of a speech he once gave, Message to Mankind, Our Civilization, Its Problem and Solution, Will the Eternal Dream of True Peace and Brotherhood Among All the People of the World Ever Become a Reality? The answer to this question will soon be known, for the next few years ahead are extremely critical ones, and depending on the actions of mankind during this time, we will either emerge as a civilization into a new golden age, or pass into oblivion, as a result of self-destruction. The following more specifically outlines the understanding of this great world problem, and its solution. Our civilization is facing a great problem, and during the last few years it has become a critical one. Its existence is not the fault of any race, creed, or political faction, but is purely the result of natural tendencies. It is an extremely simple problem, and like most simple things, its importance has been overlooked by too many of our people. Also, like all simple problems, the solution is inherent in the complete understanding of the problem. In order to understand it thoroughly, it is necessary to state it in the simplest possible terms. There are three types or branches of science that are necessary for the proper development of mankind: the spiritual science, the social science, and the physical or material science. The spiritual and social sciences must come first. There can be no development of the material science unless there first exists a foundation of the spiritual and social sciences. You can prove this to yourself by considering the difference between man and the animals. The animal has no spiritual or social science, and consequently has never developed a material science. A few of the insects, such as the ant and the bee, have developed a rudimentary form of social science, to the extent that they are able to live together in large numbers, work together for the mutual welfare, and have a form of discipline that is common to all. As a result of this, they also have developed a very limited material science, in that they do erect structures and store food against a future time of need. The fact, however, that they have no spiritual science has proven an absolute bar to further development, with the result that they have not advanced a single step in thousands of years. Mankind, on the other hand, has, from the very beginning of his development, sensed the fact that there is a supreme power and intelligence that pervades and controls all nature. Man's attitude toward this power has varied from fear and resentment to reverence and love, but always he has had the desire to learn more of the nature of this power. Thus the spiritual science had its beginning in the very dawn of human intelligence, with the realization that man could improve the conditions of his life only by cooperation. Came the first tribal gatherings that were the beginning of the social science. From the foundation provided by these two sciences, the superstructure of the material science began to emerge, and here begins the problem. The development of the material science, being constantly stimulated by the ever-increasing needs and desires of the body, progresses normally according to the square of time. This too, you can prove to yourself if you consider the inventions and material developments that have taken place within the last 30 of our years. Compare them with the development of the previous 100 years, and then compare that in turn with the previous 1,000 years. You will see at once that the development of the material science takes place at a rate that is constantly accelerating. The spiritual and social sciences, on the other hand, progress normally, only directly with time, and even this rate of progress is not always maintained. You now have the problem of a huge and massive structure, growing at an ever-increasing rate, standing upon and supported only by a foundation that is growing at a much smaller rate. It is obvious that unless some means are found to stimulate greatly the growth of the foundation, A time will inevitably come when the structure will collapse upon that foundation, bringing ruin and destruction to both. Our race is now in constant danger of total destruction by an agency that itself has produced. Why should a people be menaced by their own creations? Simply because they have not progressed far enough in the spiritual and social sciences to enable them to determine the uses to which their creations shall be put. If reduced to the simplest terms, social science is the study of man's relationship to his fellow man. The spiritual science is the study of man's relationship to God. The indispensable requirement for progress in either of these sciences is a sincere desire for a better understanding. The solution to our problem is not as complex as it may seem. We must learn to understand ourselves, we must learn the laws of the universe, and live by them. When we have achieved this, love follows automatically. That the three sciences must grow proportionately with each other is a great lesson, and should be the first thing taught to our youth throughout the world. Whether or not mankind surpasses the point of self-destruction will be determined entirely upon how many people truly understand our problem and eagerly work toward its solution. Responsibility of repairing the foundation of our civilization depends and rests upon each individual equally. It is through our lack of understanding that incredible acts of violence are committed. We cover our trail and hope to escape exposure. A man who gives private lectures to a off-zero group was approached by two men who identified themselves as government agents. They warned the man not to insult the U.S. government. He replied that he had no intention of doing that. Said the more senior agent, "Do you know what happened in Guyana? It was a government assassination to eradicate the whole group. You might remember the incident. A congressman and a news reporter were also killed there. The bodies then rotted in the sun for a week, and no fingerprint could be made." With a greater understanding of the universe, they would have known that the only judgment that matters is made by an entity from which concealments cannot be made.